and in a clear sky. Had some wonderful weather here in Dhaka. Very hot today, but the clear blue sky, sunshine all the way through, packed crowd, and Asia at the moment in control. Just looking at the teams, with the exception of the wicketkeepers, everyone has bowled, and bowled not just as an occasional bowler in limited overs cricket. But everyone in the two teams can be called on by his captain to do a job.
He has great strength not only in the batting but also in the bowling. Asia 11, pretty handy. All these players from Asia 11 can bowl. The rest of the world are also pretty handy with the ball.
Oh, lovely bowling, Mooney.
Yeah, only Callis and Johnson, apart from the keeper Gilchrist, were not called on to bowl in the Asia 11. And we know that both Callis and Johnson are very capable medium pace, fast medium swing bowlers. Rushing through their overs here. 31 gone, 168 for four. Youngsters in the crowd tonight, and they'll go home and talk for a long time about the innings they saw from Sachin Tendulkar, stroke play they saw from Mark Waugh. And at the moment looks as if they ought to be talking about a nation victory, but who knows. Michael Bevan has played very well. He's got the dangerous Lance Klusner and the equally dangerous Adam Gilchrist to come with him. 168 for four. We have another 19 overs remaining in the commentary box now. Ravi Shastri and with him Mike Proctor.
Thank you, Tony. Sachin Tendulkar continuing. And he's pulled that. And once again, he's hit it in the gap. Venkatragman not sure. I just get the feeling it might have bounced once and then gone over the rope. Boundary signal. And he's played the shot very effectively.
So effective. He found the gap, did Michael Bevan. 79. Just 73 deliveries faced. And if the rest of the world are going to win this game, they've got two of the best in the world at the crease.
One thing amazing about Michael Bevan is that you don't notice him scoring that quickly. That's because he's such an excellent runner between the wickets. He runs hard, picks up the ones and twos. And between that, he hits the boundaries. And he's got the perfect partner in Klusner.
Huge appeal, but I don't think anyone's too interested.
He's comfortably home. A good thing from the rest of the world point of view is that Klusner has got a start. He didn't get that in the last three innings he played at international level. And like I mentioned earlier, that this pitch might just be the one that will suit him.
stride rate now for the rest of the world. Just over 8 runs per over. And two men, as I said, at the crease.
Oh, my boy!
Anyone in the world can achieve it. It's these two. And Gilchrist to come.
Unless they need these two to carry on for another 7 or 8 overs. Because like we mentioned, they don't bat deep the rest of the world. And once again he's played that shot. Second time he's done that. And this time he's cleared the boundary quite comfortably. So he ends the over in style here with a 6.
The leg spinner just a fraction short by the master. And Michael Bevan, he's got it right in the middle. Well, not quite, but he's so powerful. It goes over the rope. Over the rope's good enough at 6.
It's 180 for 4. The run here continuing.
Ravi was talking about not much batting to come. Gilchrist certainly one of the best strikers in the world, but from there on in, well, Caddick Rose, Haywood and Tufnell, they're not going to set the world alight, I don't think.
Is there?
Just a slight alteration in the field now. Jayasurya going to a slip position.
It's been a marvelous crowd here this evening and you just feel some anticipation in the crowd. They think something might happen. And, as we know, these two such wonderful strikers. They're expecting it. And that's what they expected. Not quite that. But it's a little bit of turn from Murlitharan. And it's a good catch. It slipped. And this crowd come alight again. Jayasurya the man. And that's good captaincy by Wasim Akram, having a slip in for Klusner. And it pays dividends.
Now this is extremely good cricket by the Sri Lankans. Wasim Akram is not on the field, Sanath Jayasurya is captaining the side. He knows his bowler better than anybody. He very quickly moved from a mid-wicket position to a slip. And in 2 balls time, he was rewarded. Klusner goes for 16, 180 for 5.
It's a fool's paradise during April on UK TV. Welcome to St. Jude Mental Hospital, where the patients are not always switched on, but always tuned in to Radio Gaga. Catch their hilarious antics in Taken Over the Asylum. Politically correct or incorrect, the answers aren't always black and white. It's the ultimate neighborhood watch program, Love Thy Neighbor. Jack and Beth have left Cardale for Africa. Back at the beaches, Will is fighting to save the practice and keep his family from breaking apart. Peak practice. Last year saw Kate Blanchett take out Best Actress. Can she make it a double along with Australia's own Russell Crowe? Don't miss the Orange British Academy Film Awards for 2000. Select a warm wash on the dial, add some lust, pride and gluttony, and before you know it, out comes Family Affairs, Coronation Street and EastEnders. A brighter and whiter April only on UK TV.
180 for 5, Adam Gilchrist comes out to the centre. Normally opens the batting for Australia, but the reason why he's here is this is what happened. Good piece of bowling by Murlitharan. He threw it up there for Klusner to play the cover drive. Jayasurya making no mistake.
And Jayasurya, who knows Murlitharan so well, he almost takes his catch as if he knew it was going to happen. Relaxed, casual. Thanks very much.
That was a good piece of captaincy, and now he's on the attack. Even for Gilchrist, he's standing at that slip position. What a difference he's made to the Australian side ever since he's come in. Not only at test match level, but also in the one-day internationals.
Hundreds, 1350s, strike rate just under the 90s, averaging 33. That is a tremendous record. And a tremendous over by Muralitharan. Really very effective. Rest of the world now struggling a bit. 180 for 5.
So 180 for 5, 33 overs have been bowled. Chamindar Vaas, he's opened the attack with Wasim Akram. Brilliant catch to dismiss Mark Waugh. And Tendulkar continuing here. And Mohan Khan just having a word with Tendulkar. Maybe just getting the field right on the onside. We saw Bevan looking to hit him twice in the previous over, in fact hit him successfully. And you won't see this happen ever on a cricket field, at least you wouldn't have seen it for a long time. Mohan Khan having a chat with Tendulkar. That's good to see. This match extremely well supported, not only by the cricket-loving public of Bangladesh, but also the players. One spare of thought for the players. A lot of them have left venues where their countries are playing cricket and come out here to play this game.
Yourself.
Was that a drop catch? Sachin Tendulkar into his third over, having conceded 18 runs of his first two. So a bit of a gamble here. Let's have a look at this again. The crowd got excited. I think the commentary got excited as well. But it certainly was a bum ball.
Who loves to cut and pull, Adam Gilchrist. He also plays the sweep shot well. Robin Singh out as a substitute for Wasim Akram. They look for two here. They get it comfortably.
Two Australians, tremendous one-day players. They know what's required. It's runs and scored at a rate, and the rate is about 8.5 runs per over. That is a huge ask, and these are probably the last two who can do it for the rest of the world.
$185 for was firmly struck. This is the last ball of the previous over. And Gilchrist couldn't get out of the way. Still got a single. Just pushing himself there. The required run rate now has jumped to 8.5. Jaya Surya here has inflicted a bowling change. He's brought back Razak. A little expensive in his first spell, but he does have the ability to get some reverse swing. And he can be pretty nippy. Full house here at the Bangabandhu Stadium. Stadium, it can seat about 38,000 people, but one would imagine that there are about 50,000 in here, if not more. Already have been treated to some real exciting cricket. People of all ages here watching the cricket. Razak on his way. And he starts off with a slower delivery.
Slow ball and then almost an attempted bouncer. Very short delivery, whacked it in. Nice pace and bounce as far as the batsman is concerned. It's one thing you know on this wicket, you know how the ball's going to come off the wicket in terms of pace and most of the time in terms of bounce as well.
Looking to hit across the line, has missed it altogether. The rest of the world have lost their sixth wicket.
And the crowd loved it. They're on their feet again. And the Zach strikes there for the Asian team. Gilchrist, I think, a shot too early. He hasn't been at the wicket too long. And the Zach strikes. Gilchrist lost at 7 deliveries for his one, and the rest of the world now struggling. 6 down for 186.
Golf's greatest legends at the Seniors Championship Friday morning at 2, live on Fox Sports.
Give me a visual.
View screen on.
On this date, this man at this station will bring you this show for this long.
Splendid.
That's right, for 24 hours, cancel all plans of sleep, because it's just going to be you, your TV, and one heck of a long trek across the galaxy.
Great.
So, pull up a comfy chair and settle in for a 24-hour trek-a-thon, 22nd of April on TV1.
May 2000 on Fox Sports. More victory, more glory, more history-making events than ever before. It's crunch time in the Amy Super 12 with the qualifying rounds, the semi-finals and the grand final exclusively live. The NRL season fires up on Fox Sports with live coverage of 9 quality league clashes during the month of May. We keep the red counter ticking with the Superbike World Championship and the World Motorcycle Championships exclusively live. Watch the drama unfold as the Premier League season reaches its exciting climax and join a 70,000 strong crowd at Wembley for the FA Cup Final live on Fox Sports. 2 weeks of play court action from the battlefields of Roland Garros, the second Grand Slam event of the year, the French Open, live. the future of sport. May 2000 on Fox Sports.
Welcome back to Dhaka. Now with me is the president of the ICC, Mr. Jagmohan Dalmia. And Mr. Dalmia, can I begin by asking you about the rather serious allegations which have come out of India concerning one or two South African players?
It's not good for the image of the cricket. It's a very unfortunate controversy. We are very closely watching the day-to-day situation. At the moment, we are in Dhaka. We are awaiting. All the facts and the details are not in our hands. But as soon as it comes to our hands, we will be going ahead with it. And we are quite serious in the matter. But this is too early for us to comment only on some newspaper report. We have to wait.
So once you get the full details, you'll then be prepared to make a full statement?
Of course, we will decide our line of action. We have got certain procedures laid in our, rather how we proceed in these kind of the matters. And we have to look into it. Police is examining, that has added another dimension, and therefore we have to look into, we have to also interact, but we have decided to cooperate with the police authorities.
Which is really the only course of action you can take at this stage.
Of course, we have to wait and see, but one thing I can tell you that we are very serious about it, and if there is any substance in it, so far nothing has come forward, but if it is there is substance in it, we will not allow this matter to be swept under the carpet.
Well, thank you very much for that. Now let's move on to a rather happier subject, and that is Cricket Week itself. You must be delighted with what you see here.
Of course, I'm very delighted, very encouraged, because this is a part of the globalization. We are trying to bring the awareness among the people throughout the world, and the success of this is very, very important to us, because whether it is going to be one-off event or whether it is going to be a regular feature will be decided on the success of it, and we have got a very encouraging response.
Mr. Dalmia, thank you very much indeed. The cricket's restarted. Let's go back to the commentary box.
Okay, thank you.
Interesting thoughts there from Rao Tella and Jagmohan Dalmia. That might just be a serious problem, what's happening in India. Just to inform our viewers as to what exactly is happening in India. There have been a couple of players accused for match fixing. And that was what Mr. Dalmia was speaking about. They're going to wait, be cautious. Wait for the police to actually come out with whatever substance they have before they make any announcement. Meanwhile, in the center, Franklin Rose has come out here for the rest of the world. Abdul Razak brought back into the attack, striking in his very first over. Picked up the wicket of Gilchrist. And he almost got Bevan there. 187 for six. Five overs have been bowled, 187 for six. Michael Bevan still going strong, but the crowd here anticipating an Asian 11 win. Now that was the wicket of Gilchrist. He's looking to hit across the line. Missed it altogether. Tendulkar starting off with a leg break here to Rose.
Franklin Rose, he missed that altogether as well. I don't know whether he thought it was the off break or leg break. It was a perfectly pitched leg break. That's not so perfectly pitched leg break, but it's a leg break and swept away for four. That's a beautiful shot. Rose knows he can wait for the bad ball. A guy like Tendulkar. Just bowled a beauty. This one, a loose one.
He's no mug with the bat. He has contributed for the West Indies of late. This time it spins the other way.
I don't think Franklin Rose picked the one that went from off the leg.
He's got hold of that one, but Ganguly will cut it off. If the rest of the world had to get anywhere close to the Asian 11 score, I think Michael Bevan will have to play a major role. He's in sight of 100 here. The required run rate is creeping up all the time. It's 193 for six. Overs remaining, and Abdul Razak here continuing. 7 boundaries, 2 sixes. Rest of the world have had is that they've lost too many wickets. The Asian 11 got a really good start. Good second wicket partnership going for them.
And these quick singles really aren't going to help the cause. Run rate well over 9 runs per over. Michael Bevan close to his 100, that's his 93rd run. And that yellow worm just slowly dipping down, getting further and further away from the white one.
Franklin Rose there hurried into the shot. To hit the deck of the Razak can be very deceptive.
Well, they might just get that. I think they are anticipating a victory here, and might be a big one.
To get from 80 balls. No one's still leaving the stadium.
More difficult for the rest of the world. Razak really is bang on target. 5 deliveries this over. Razak just 3 runs. Over 8 required, 9.5.
A zap on the pads. Always look close. So Razak has struck once again. And the seventh wicket has gone down here for the rest of the world. It's 196 for seven.
Good bowling by Razak. Really deceived Frankton Rose, and that is stone dead. It's plum. It would have hit that middle stump. Dave Orchard says, I'm afraid, Frankton, you've got to go. And Frankton Rose really can't believe it. But he's on his way. He's gone for seven. And the rest of the world really up against it now. 196 for seven.
This Fox Sports golf calendar is proudly brought to you by Han Premium Lights. The US PGA Tour continues in April with the US Masters, Seniors Championship, MCI Classic and Greater Greensboro Classic, while Golf Australia tees off every Tuesday night at 7:30 Eastern. This Fox Sports golf calendar was proudly brought to you by Han Premium Lights.
Rules for successful talk. Only speak when spoken to.
That is wrong! Yes.
Always speak the truth.
That's the order of the court.
Always offer good advice.
Act like you don't know what I'm talking about, okay?
Always play fair.
I just want to know, ladies, where is the Marine?
Always be a good listener.
I will comply and do that.
Never talk back.
That's a load of garbage.
I had to use this to break up the fight.
Oh, then
if you're not making
talk rules on FX.
Rugby Union, the Amy Super 12 continues with the qualifying rounds, the semi-finals and the grand final, exclusively live. That's Fox Sports in May.
196 for seven. Andy Caddick has come out to the centre. The last man to go was Franklin Rose. This would have hit middle stump, no doubt about that. Not much footwork. Beach anchor to the crease and up went the finger. The height was pretty good too. And wickets have been falling at regular intervals here for the rest of the world. There's only Michael Bevan, 93 of 86. And the Asian 11 bowling has been impressive. Muralidharan bowled an excellent spell. 7 overs, 2 for 24. And now Razak doing the job. 2 wickets for him. So Muralidharan back into the attack, and in the commentary box now Ralph Teller and Ramiz Raja.
Thank you very much, Ravi. And things looking just a little bit grim for the rest of the world side. 196 for 7. And not a great length of tail to come, or not very much potential for run scoring from the tail. Every run proving very valuable. Andrew Caddick is capable of scoring some runs, but possibly not against bowling of this quality in these sort of circumstances. Ramiz Raja, just how highly do you rate Muthiah Muralidharan?
He's an extremely good bowler and a very clever bowler. Bowls from wide of the crease, close of the stumps, and has developed a straighter delivery, which has got him plenty of wickets in the one-day form. Similar to a bowler who bowls big in-swingers and certainly develops that straighter delivery, even if he doesn't get the away swinger, but that becomes very effective. Murali also is in a similar mould as a spinner.
Some of the distinguished guests here, Mr. Jagmohan Dalmia, the president of ICC, who you heard from just a moment ago, Saba Chowdhury, the president of the Bangladesh Cricket Board. And there are lots of distinguished guests here. People have been flocking in. In the background there, you can just see the United Nations resident director here in Dhaka. It's a mighty blow. And no doubt about that one. And that's an impressive way to bring up his 100. What a wonderful way to do it. Michael Bevan, he might not be going to be on the winning side, who knows, but it certainly is a very, very fine performance by Michael Bevan. 88 balls, 7 fours, 3 sixes, and he really has justified his place in this side.
What a lovely look by Muir Litheran. Goes down as a leg bye, so he won't be too upset. 208 for 7, 38 overs bowled. For 7, 100 for this man, Michael Bevan. 113 runs from 72 balls. You are going to have to put your money on the Asian side. But I just wonder what Michael Bevan has got left. It's a fine effort. This is Razak. And Caddick didn't know too much about that one.
Razak is pretty swift with his pace, off the pitch especially, getting that reverse swing also. That one jagged back just a little and Caddick seemed to have missed it completely. Just 18 one-day matches for Andrew Caddick. Pretty good strike rate of 84.8, that is when he strikes the ball. He has to strike it really to get that strike rate going.
Not necessarily the sort of man you want coming in with 113 runs still to win. And only 12 overs remaining. But I can tell you, he did have a net here yesterday, just to try and get into some sort of nick. Can't say he looked in great nick while he was having the net, mind you, but that's beside the point. Perhaps he was saving it for today. Nothing wrong with that. Finds the gap, takes a single.
This was nicely played by Andrew Caddick. Difficult stroke. Moving delivery and playing it through the onside. Good, nice balance as well. Cricket is a funny game, as we all know, and anything can happen. And all will depend on Bevan, how he approaches this game. 9.74. So they need to pick up a boundary in every over.
That's a mighty shot. He won't get a boundary for it on this occasion, but he really manufactured it well. Found the gap, back to the square on the offside. Go through for a couple of runs.
This is beautifully struck. What is great to watch is his running. Still sailing through. He's an extremely fit cricketer. Conditions are pretty oppressive. They have been right throughout the day. And Bevan has run the singles well. Still concentrating.
To be honest, that was a bit of a slog, but I think when you've got 102 on the board, you're entitled to that. He must be very, very tired, and it's a formidable effort in concentration as well as batsmanship to score 100 in these conditions.
It's a huge ask, especially when the wickets have been falling. He's stood there in outstanding innings. This is why he's probably the best one-day player in world cricket today. Bevan.
Well, I don't think Caddick would reckon to be the best batsman or to be challenging Michael Bevan, even the best right-hander, but at the end of the 39th over, 212 for 7. the progressive rates. And as you can see, the fall of wickets, as ever in one-day cricket, is always going to have an effect on the scoring rate. And at one time, they got very, very close. One time, you see, early on the innings, they were right up there, but then fell away with the fall of wickets. And now it's a very, very big ask for the rest of the world side. Perhaps a little bit of help in seeing the ball better, but if the batsmen see it better, so too will the fielders. The crowd has stayed right to the end. They will be here right at the end. Probably be a few more come in when the game finishes and they take the security off the gates. There'll be a few that come in, and in a dozen years' time, they'll say, oh yes, there'll be 100,000 people that said they were there on the evening when Asia played the rest of the world. Wasim Akram, the captain. And it looks as if Wasim Akram will probably be receiving the CricketNext.com Cup at the end of this game, the way things are going. But who knows what this man might be able to do.
Maybe pick up the MVP award. It's fairly good player. Because he has been for his team.
Yes, they've got a Man of the Match award and the Most Valuable Player award for the Royal Stag. And it's a magnificent trophy, I've seen it, and it's really worth winning. And it's nice. Usually the Man of the Match award goes to someone on the winning side. But who's to say that this evening it might not go to someone on the losing side? This man had a little bit of a say in the way things went during the Asian innings. Now he's bowling these very effective little medium pacers. That's a leg spinner.
Yes, Sachin can bowl that leg spinner really well. Difficult for the tail enders to pick that one.
Come on!
Just the one run. It's interesting when you see Andrew Caddick and Michael Bevan in the same picture as we did a moment ago. The different colouring on their kit. Caddick at this end, Bevan at the other. It looks as if he's wearing a shade darker. It's just perspiration that's caused that. He must be a very fit man to keep going as he has. He's got to be fit to get back. Neat effort. Michael Bevan, who bowled his full quota of 10 overs. So he really has earned his place in this side. Big appeal. Venkat not particularly impressed. A leg bite. I think he's enjoying it. 40 overs bowled, 217 for 7.